Hi friends, welcome back to my this channel, Shruti Desai's lecture on law. We are learning mediation and today is the last session of the topic of mediation. Today we are going to learn section 89 of the Code of Civil Procedure and the Commercial Courts Act 2015 and the Ordinance of May 2018. Somewhere in 2002, Code of Civil Procedure was amended, and in that, since the hearing of cases were piling on, so the government thought it fit to have a provision of alternative dispute redressal, so that Section 89 was inserted and amended, and during the course of hearing, when if the court feels or otherwise also that there is a chance of settlement in this matter before the court, it can refer to arbitration. Now this arbitration cannot be without agreement, mutual agreement of the parties. So if parties agree, court would refer the matter to the arbitrator, either suggested by the parties or suggested by the court and agreed upon by the parties. Similarly, it can refer for conciliation. We have studied the conciliation in the first lecture number 1 and 2. We have Lok Adalat since last so many years. We have Panchayat also. So, all these are forums where people can settle that their differences of opinion or a dispute without going to court of law. And thirdly, concept of mediation, that is alternative dispute redressal, was inserted or introduced in the Code of Civil Procedure. It did not move much from 2002 till 2015, when Commercial Courts Act came into picture and it was enacted. The Commercial Courts Act is passed in 2015, and it directed, there is a direction of constitution of commercial courts at every divisional level, and High Court should have a commercial division, appellate court also should be there, even at district level there has to be a commercial court. Now what is commercial dispute? All disputes relating to transactions or finance transaction, then we have aircraft purchase agreement, then we have JVs, joint venture agreement, management and consultancy, shareholders agreement, then subscription and investment agreements pertaining to service industry, including outsources, services and financial services, mercantile agency and mercantile usage, partnership agreements, technology development agreements, export and import of merchandise or services, ordinary transactions of merchant bankers, financiers and traders, such as relating to mercantile documents, including enforcement and interpretation of such documents, insurance, oil exploitation and explorations and gas reserves, and such other commercial dispute, intellectual property disputes. In this there is an explanation which says that a commercial dispute shall not cease to be a commercial dispute merely because it also involves action for recovery of immovable property, for realization of money out of immovable property given as security, or involves any other relief pertaining to immovable property, or one of the contracting parties, state or any of his agencies or instrumentalities, or a private body carrying out public function. In such case also, it is a commercial transaction. Section 34, appeal or a petition filed under Arbitration Act is also now treated as commercial dispute. So this is about the Commercial Courts Act. Now, as far as valuation is concerned, lowest value is 3 lakh and upper value is to be decided by state government in consultation with the High Court. So if I take example of Maharashtra, so the city civil court has jurisdiction up to 1 crore. So mediation of the matter, mediation matters, commercial dispute up to 1 crore would go to city civil court, and above 1 crore it would go to High Court. So this is the setup which is suggested in this 2015 act. In this, there is also a provision to transfer the pending suits to Commercial Division Court once it is constituted. Now let us see the ordinance of 2018. What does it provide? 2018 ordinance was promulgated on 3rd of May 2018, and it has various provisions of law, provisions, but basically it suggests that if there is no urgency in the matter, if you don't require any immediate relief in the matter, the matter should not move to the court before it is pre-mediated. So pre-mediation in commercials, this is a good move by the government to reduce the backlog of hearing. What I suggest is even students and all the trained mediators must get a chance. So we have so many cases pending, why not to allot pending cases, each one, you know, must get one or two matters and try it out whether it gets settled or not. Nowadays group of students also learn ADR, and why not to give them during their course of training as a student of law the cases for settlement of dispute. This is what is my suggestion. Maybe the new generation is successful in solving the dispute much faster because they are trained in a very professional manner. So each mediator must get at least five pending suits, and government must try this. It is a suggestion. It may work, it may not work, but it is a we must always give a try. And with this, we come to end of our lecture series on mediation. We will now start with RERA after a brief break. Thank you.